It's just the emotion Michael used to bring to me, yeah.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
As I've got older and I've clocked that, the whole time he was here, yeah, all he was trying to do is just promote love. It goes hand in hand, really. The poetry or the rap. The verse is the truth, and that's what it is. What was the question?
Hang on.
It's music. This is like 2 years after I've come back from Ghana and I'm playing football. All I wanted to do, and it just, I just got to a point where I just became a bit disillusioned with football and what I wanted to do with it, and also I started smoking, so my mind was just in a, I felt like I was almost like throwing away everything I'd ever worked for my whole life prior to that. It was one night at my mind with Cavani, we were just burning some trees, as you do. He's the freestyle of a group of boys and they're all rapping. And I can never rap. One day, I can't explain it, what happened, but it just came out. Next day at college, my head is down, just writing bars, and just continued from there. And then along the way, I found purpose attached to it. In terms of writing, I've always been trying to find the best way to say what I'm trying to say, but I haven't found it yet. I was like, oh, it's possible. If I could be out there for everyone to hear, I'd have so much to say. So it was like, the fact that I did it that one night, I was like, I can actually do it. Let me see what I can do. Just kept writing everything. Onto the page, what I couldn't do, or what I wasn't able to do, or what I wanted to do. We got baptized. At the same time, Kamani, my twin sister, and shortly after, it was Jasmine as well, baptized. So it was all in the same period. Not kind of, it completely changed our perspective. My perspective on life, on why I'm here, on what's important and what's not. So I felt like I had a responsibility to share that message of salvation, of a higher truth, something more, you know? So it's made me grow in my own understanding of everything. So I kind of pulled away from even from church or from religion. But I felt like I had something had been put in me to say, to share, even if it's not to bring anyone else in to make them aware, it's to make me aware of what I can do. But with the music, since I put the ball aside, it's like I've realised that the greatness has been within me. Like, whatever I apply myself to, I will be great at. And also I know that I've got a great relationship with people and to be able to communicate with people. So music is like the key to like everything that I've ever wanted to actually do. All I can do is show you my truth. I can't impose it upon you. I can't tell you this is right and this is wrong. This is the way you should live and this is the way you shouldn't live. Because my life is so unique to myself and your life is so unique to yourself. But the best I can do in terms of uplifting one another, being as honest as I can about my truth and who I feel like. Honesty. Like you can tell an artist who is doing this for the love of it, because they feel like they have to do. Who's doing this because they feel like if they're not doing this, then they're not fulfilling their purpose. Kind of. This is my artist, yeah. Honesty, truth, yeah, your truth, as unapologetic as you can be. That's what I admire most an artist. If you ain't got nothing to give, that's gonna. If it's not growing you, like if it's keeping you stagnant in your mindset. If it's keeping you stagnant in your approach to whatever you're trying to do, it's not what's gonna spark that in you. Like, you're gonna get tired of it and it's gonna exhaust. Actually, you'll either realize that and you'll grow and you'll evolve through that, or you'll get swallowed up by it and just be forgotten and blown away by the wind. Only the real is gonna last.
Yeah, I don't
know. Here today. Cherries. My mum, all my mum's music. Anita Baker, Nora Jones, Amy. But Amy was more for my big sister. Erica, Jill Scott, Usher, St. Michael, Luther, Chase. Like, it was all soul. And in terms of the rap side of it, my mum liked Kanye. Yeah, so that's the kind of music that was in our house. I'm not listening to Cole and Kendrick and Nas and Joey and those guys there. Then I'm listening to Erica and Jill and Anita. I love both, I just love to say it. And the music gives me a way to have more fun in it and get lost in it a bit more than without the music. But without the music also allows me to connect with people on a much more guy, he was a friend of my sister, who, if you met him, you know, you feel him instantly kind of thing. And he inspired me to just like, to break that barrier that I was trying to break and just be like as unapologetic as possible. So in terms of the writing of the poetry, I was able to just like strip away any beat, any sound, and just be like, this is what I have to say. Saying about, you know, writing within that, the boundaries of it, just like free write. And I got hooked on that, you know? But I went through a phase where I was only writing like that. And I was even thinking, I don't think I'm going to do this rap thing anymore, because this, the way I'm doing this poetry and spoken word, it's so like free, like there's no boundary. But in that time, it improved my writing capabilities anyway. If I could give one thing to people, it would be for us all to learn to love ourselves irrespective of everything, to find that security within yourself regardless of anyone's opinion or anything that's going on, to identify yourself with that divinity that we all are, that we all have, and share it, because that's why we're all here, because we all have that. Everybody has something that we all need, that has been given to you to share.